The criteria you choose for your model will be based on the objectives of your analysis. To start, you should try to develop a detailed objective statement and use that to define a list of criteria. For example, let's assume we have to address the following scenario. The Arcata Fire Protection District has decided to explore the possibility of updating their facilities and relocating the existing fire departments serving the cities of Arcata and McKinleyville. There are currently 3 fire stations in this district. A number of potential alternative sites for each of the existing stations has been identified, but it is not certain which location will optimize services between these 2 cities. An analysis of the service calls indicates that most calls are not related to actual fires, but instead involve other categories such as motor vehicle accidents and medical assistance calls. The Arcata Fire Department has a detailed history of incident responses for the past 7 years. They have a preferred response time of 2 minutes when determining a service area, but can extend a service area that includes a 5-minute response time. Your objective statement might be, the objective of this analysis is to evaluate the potential locations of new fire stations compared with the locations of existing fire stations, factoring in the volume of service calls with a response time window of 2 to 5 minutes. Based on this objective statement, you might define our criteria as the following: a history of incident responses over 7 years, the frequency of calls at each location, the location of alternative sites from Arcata to McKinleyville, the location of existing fire stations, a 2-minute response time window, and a 5-minute response time window, which captures the greatest demand based on incident history. A comparison between alternative sites and existing fire stations based on demand weight allocated to each facility, a limit of only 3 fire stations total that can be chosen by the model as the best candidates. The demand points for this model would be the history of incident responses. The facilities would be the existing and alternative fire stations. The allocation cost factors would include the volume of incident responses and the distance from the facilities. Our impedance cutoff would be an area defined first by a 2-minute response time window, then by a 5-minute response window. The 3 final candidates would be chosen based on the total allocated demand weight. Allocated demand weight. Allocated demand weight is the allocated sum of the effective demand from all demand points that were assigned to the facility. In this scenario, our demand points are weighted by the frequency of calls at a specific location. A neighborhood with a history of many incident responses will have more weight than an area with only a few. Demand weight can decay with distance, so that as demand points land farther from a facility, less weight is allocated from that point. So for example, let's say that neighborhood A has a higher volume of calls than neighborhood B, and we want to allocate demand for these 2 points to the Arcata Fire Station. If distance was not a factor, you could say that neighborhood A would allocate a greater demand weight to the Arcata Fire Station than neighborhood B. However, if we determined that demand weight decayed with distance, neighborhood A might allocate less demand weight than neighborhood B if it is farther away from the Arcata Fire Station. And if neighborhood A is beyond the 5-minute impedance cutoff window, it won't have any weight at all. The best location for a fire station would be the one with the most allocated demand weight.